My name's Megan Norrington and I am a Year 3-4 teacher here at Humpty Do Primary School. My classroom consists of 24 students. A large majority of them are English as additional language students, some Indigenous, and students who require special support while learning. The intended learning of today's lesson was to consolidate the skills that they use when reading and decoding a word problem to find an answer. When they were first presented with word problems, I found that a lot of them were grabbing the numbers out of the problem and adding them. They weren't reading the whole question, finding out what it was actually asking them, and then applying the right mathematical concept to find the answer. In order to deal with that problem, I had a professional conversation with Jeff Gilman, the assistant principal here at Humpty Do Primary, and he suggested I have a look and research Newman's analysis for error. Newman's analysis is the understanding of how children read and decode a problem. So they need to ask themselves, do I understand what this problem's asking me? What is it asking me to do? Then they need to pull out the mathematical part of that word problem and transfer it into some form of a sum, and then they need to decode it. So I picked 36 apples. I know 36 is a key part of my problem. What is my next important part, Jason?
There was an even amount on each tree.
Okay, do we agree? Is that an important piece of information?
Yes.
There was an
even. Yes.
Okay. Now, we've read, we've made sure we understand. How can I solve this problem? What are some tools you can use to help you work this problem out?
After we explored the word problem with the class, they received that word problem on a piece of paper and they went to their tables and independently solved that problem. So by using a manipulative such as counters or a drawing, it enables them to touch and to see and to physically move them around to get to their answer. So they don't lose track, it's not all just in their head. I used an open-ended problem today, one to extend those learners who are capable of solving a word problem. It gives them a chance to go above and beyond the one answer. For those students that require a little bit of support, by posing an open-ended question, they know that they start with 36 and that they just have to figure out how to put those counters or their apples into even groups. The focus group that I had to work with, they're my students who need special support from the teacher. So they basically need the teacher to model what they have to do. They need teacher assistance to count up, to read the problem for them, to solve it, to be able to get to the end of the problem. To conclude today's lesson, I asked all the students to come back to the floor with their problems. From then, we recapped on the skills we needed. We read the problem again. They then got to share how they answered their problem. We were able to use different types of language, so if they've given me an extended addition, we were then able to put that into a times table. We were using the mathematical language of groups of
12. So I can turn this into 3 times. Does that still give me 36?
Yes.
How can I turn that into something different? I can spin it around. So that means I would have what faith?
12 times 3 equals 36.
So I would have 12 groups, and how many in each group, Jason?
3.
Okay. So how many trees would I have had for this sum?
4 trees.
4 trees. How many apples were on each one?
9.
From then, reflected on what they learnt, that gives me a little bit of feedback.
And in that reflection phase, the students will share their learning. They might share problems and strategies they've used. From that, the teacher can gauge, to some degree, the success of the lesson, and maybe if there are still misconceptions around a topic that has been taught.
Who can tell me something they learned today in maths?
I was using counters and pictures.
So you were using counters and pictures to help you do what?
Solve the answers.
To solve the answer or to solve the word problem?
The word problem.
Okay. Does it help that you can see your counters?
Yes.
And you can touch your counters?
Yes.
And you can move them around?
Yes.
So if they can't tell me perhaps that I started with 36 apples, so I knew all I had to do was put them in even groups, that lets me pick up any misconceptions they might have to then follow them up in a following lesson.